Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's Salesforce video, we're going to talk about something quite important for Salesforce administrators, and that is sharing rules. So when you set up a Salesforce-based application, I'm not talking about the standard CRM offering here, right? So we are going to talk about custom objects and custom development. It pretty much applies to the standard offering objects as well, although there are some differences, which I will not mention in this video, okay? So here we will talk about the custom objects. Right, so remember from the previous videos, we had developed a Lightning application that's called Speedy Sales, which is a totally imaginary application, right? For this training purposes. And we have purchase orders and speedy products as custom objects, part of this Lightning app. Right. So under purchase orders, we have all these records. So these records are of type purchase order, right? And see, created by some of them were created by the system admin, the user that I'm logged in at this moment. And some other records were created by a user that's called Speedy User. Right, so this is important actually, because this will be our first distinction for record access using sharing rules, right? So let's first of all focus on this aspect of the records. Who created that record? Right. So there are different levels to record sharing. First of all, the first and the high level is the org-wide sharings. So let's go to our administration console. Right, so this is the setup and configuration section of Salesforce. And what you would do is type sharing and then click on sharing settings. Right, so this is what I mean, org-wide defaults, right? So org-wide defaults for your objects. So what are my objects? I have two of them here. The first object is purchase orders, and then the other one is speed of products. So I'm focusing right now on purchase orders. So either I can just select from here. Remember, you will have all the standard CRM objects at the top of the list. So you have to scroll all the way down to see your own custom objects, right? So here's my object here, purchase order. I'll select this one. And then it's going to show me the sharing settings for the custom object that's called purchase order. Right, so let's click on edit so you can see better. Now, when I click on edit, unfortunately, it's going to bring me the entire list of all the objects, but I can scroll all the way down and locate purchase order. So you see that purchase order is set to private and private. So what other options would I have? Public read only, public read and write. So let's keep this as private. So what that means is at the org-wide level, I'm not sharing the records with anyone at all, right? So let's take a look at the last section, which is talking about the sharing overrides per profiles, right? So the reason why with this user account, I can see all the records is because the system administrator profile has view all data, modify all data, view all and modify all for purchase orders, which means that no matter what sharing rules are defined, the system admin, the account that I'm logged in with right now, is going to see no matter what every record. Right, and is able to edit every record as well, because it has modify all permissions. Right, But obviously, this is not the case for regular users. We have one here that's called speedy user. And let's see how this user can access the records, right? So we will see step by step. Now, first of all, I have to log in as that user, but also take a look at that particular user's profile and the permission sets that that user has, right? So as the system admin, let's locate that user, open it up, and see what profile this user is logged in with, and if this user has additional permission set assignments, right? That's very interesting. So the first one is this profile, Speedy Sales regular user. So let's see if at profile level, this user has any extra permission, extra access to the purchase orders custom object. All right, so let's take a look. Let's see standard object permissions and custom object permissions. Right, so you see that at the profile level, this user would have read access and view all access to speedy products. Okay, great. Now, we know that this user has also a permission set assigned. So let's navigate back to our user and then see that this user has a speedy sales purchase orders permission sets. So let's click on this one and see what this one is about and what it gives as permissions on purchase orders object. So let's click on object settings and then navigate all the way down to purchase orders. And this permission set is only giving read access to purchase orders. Okay, so basically, this user who has the profile and the permission set assigned would still only have read access to the records. Okay, now on another tab, I was logged in actually as the speedy user, so you will see it from here, logged in as speedy user, right? Now, see the difference. This is what the speedy user is able to see. Okay? So you will immediately observe and note that the speedy user is only able to visualize the orders, the purchase orders that were created by themselves, right? By the same user. Whereas the system admin is able to see every purchase order record, right? That's interesting. Now, what you could eventually do is that you can extend the sharing settings, right? The permissions using permission sets or profiles. But then here's the trick. If you do it, if you say, for example, I'll check view all here, so that my speedy user is then able to see all records. But then that's probably not what you want because it's not like nothing or everything, right? It's not like my records versus every record in the system. So, functionally speaking, that's probably not how your system should work. So, you probably need more functional filters rather than just technical filters. What I mean by that is you will probably set sharing rules. Say, for example, based on order type, not by who created that records, but you may just, you know, list this and say, I will create a sharing rule that will give access to consumer type purchase orders so that any user that belongs to that sharing rule will be able to visualize or also edit purchase orders of type consumer, right? So how do you actually achieve that? And that is by sharing rules, right? So what exactly is a sharing rule? I have created one and I will show you how that's set up. So let's take it step by step. So you create a new sharing rule, right? Inside that object. So first of all, you navigate to sharing settings and then you locate your object and then you create a new sharing rule. Now, I created one and I called it consumer orders. Perfect. Now, share all purchase orders of type consumer order with consumer order reps. Cool. Now, select your rule type and your criteria. Field order type. Where's my field? Here. Order type equals consumer. It's as simple as that, actually. I could set other criteria, but this is just what I need in this sharing rule filter, right? I will filter all order types by consumer, and then the access level is going to be read and write. Okay. And then you see who you're sharing this with, right? So you're sharing this with a group, with a public group that's called consumer order reps. That's probably the vital part to it. So if you're creating like a new rule, let's create a new one for vendor orders. Let's copy this. Vendor orders. Cool. Now, let's say based on criteria, and my criteria is order type equals, let's select it from the list actually, vendor order, insert selected, okay, cool. Now, who am I going to share this with? I will share this with a public group. But let me create a new one, public groups. So internal orders, vendor orders, and vendor orders. Okay, I already have one actually, I already created that. So it's here, vendor order reps. So if it's a vendor order, then I will share those records with a group of people that are part actually of this vendor orders reps public group. Note all these, like these are the keywords, public group, which is under administration and public groups. And I will share those records with them. And they will be able to do what? Read or read and write. So I'll say read and write. Cool. Okay, now the system is setting up and calculating the sharing rules and sharing them actually with the people who are part of that group and everything. So now let's go inside the public groups and check who's there. Our vendor order is probably empty, right? So right now this is empty. Now, before we make the change, let's navigate to back to our speedy user. So our speedy user is able to see at the moment only the records that were created by themselves. Now, if the speedy user was able to see all the vendor orders, that's the sharing rule that we have just set up, they would be able to see two additional vendor orders created by the system admin, which they are not able to see at this moment. Okay, so which would be if we go ahead and add speedy user to the vendor order reps public group and wait until this sharing rule is calculated. So you see here, purchase order, order type equals vendor order, share that record, those records actually, with all the users who are part of the public group called vendor order reps, and they should be able to read and write. Okay. There you go. I have just refreshed the page for our speedy user. So you see that now our speedy user, because they are part of the vendor order reps public group, they are now able to see all the vendor orders, not just the ones that they created, but also the ones that were created by system admin. But please observe, speedy user is still not able to see everything. Why? Because there are some consumer orders that were also created by the system admin. They're not able to see them because we allowed the speedy user to visualize and edit all vendor orders, but not all, but not other types. Okay. So this is a good demonstration of how you can fine tune the access that you would like to grant to individuals, basically, because you are adding individuals inside public groups. First of all, you create that entire structure. Say you have your public groups. This is a group of functionally speaking similar individuals, right? So they are vendor order reps, internal order reps, you get the idea. And then you add them into those groups. This is a user account, which means it's one individual. And then you go to your sharing settings. Okay, so let's do it again. Sharing settings, you navigate there. And then you locate the object that you would like to share, purchase order. We're talking about custom objects here, but you can do the same with the standard objects. And then make sure that the org-wide defaults are set to private. Then you can fine tune this with your purchase order sharing rules, which is a lower level of sharing, right? And then you start creating your new sharing rules, basically. So again, if it's a consumer type of order, then share that with individuals that are part of the public group that's called consumer order, and so on. And then those users will immediately have the type of access that you have granted. It's either read or read and write to those records. Okay, it's immediate. Right. I hope this video was useful. It's it looks like it's a lot of information, but it follows a simple logic pattern. So feel free to ask me your questions in the comment section below the video, and I'll be happy to help. So, all right, thank you very much again. And if you take 2 seconds to give a thumbs up to this video, I will appreciate that very much. That would be great support to the channel. And see you in the next Salesforce video.